Maryland is among at least a dozen states that have banned dining out, and those who don't comply could face a $5,000 fine or even spend a year in jail. This is certainly causing some local restaurants to try and get creative here. WJZ is live tonight. Max McGee at the Rotunda with more on how those businesses are making money. Max.
Yeah, Rick, the restaurants we spoke to are using delivery services like DoorDash and Grubhub in order to help their bottom line. They also have some unique specials for the people who've given so much to them.
At Lord Baltimore Hotel downtown, the coffee machine echoes through their bakery. It reminds you of the familiar sound of business you'd hear when it used to be a busy lobby. Because of the coronavirus pandemic, LB is one of several places adjusting to the indefinite new normal delivery.
It's been fast and furious because we weren't originally part of that. It's, you know, figuring out the ins and outs and who do we need here and hours and trying to be as sustainable as we can.
Partnering with Grubhub, they're keeping it simple. Dessert pastries, sandwiches with the freshest products. They're ready to go. Have a sweet tooth? The Charmery in Hamden offers Grubhub and Uber Eats pickup and orders through their website. The popular ice cream shop is putting a special twist on it too.
$1 of every item that is sold goes into our scooper fund, which will be used for our team. We are just looking to see how we can best serve our community while keeping everyone as safe as possible.
No dine-in allowed at Moby Dick House of Kebab, but they're still serving the community.
We're focusing on the kids by giving away free kids' meals with their parents' entree. We are helping out the elderly community by giving away 20% discount plus free delivery to retirement homes.
First responders get 50% off, too. It's a way Baltimore businesses can show their charm in a time when we need it the most.
And every place we visited today all said the same thing. They're aware of the financial hit they may take, but they feel like they have to do their part in order to help the people feel like they can go back to their normal lives as quickly as possible. Live at 5:30, I'm Max McGee, WJZ.